I'm Heidi Miller from Cartel High School.
I'm Deepak Jalan from Cartel High School. And this is our third year doing this, and this is a blast. This is a whole lot of fun and great for the kids to come out and participate in. Gives them an opportunity to show off their creativity.
That's an opportunity they wouldn't get otherwise. I mean, how often do you get to paint on a vehicle legally?
And it's really like tagging, but there's no police involved.
Part of the excitement, I think, is not knowing what type of car that we're going to get, so you have to kind of plan for anything and everything. And it really pushes the students' limits and their creativity. It really makes them have to be even a little more creative. So, because once they come up with a design, then they have to adapt it to whatever car that they get. It's quite a challenge for them.
I'm Sharon Brooks from Quartzill High School also. And I think one of the awesome things about this is the kids have to think outside the box. They have to come up with a theme. They have to work as a team. And they have to create something incredible. So for me, it's like, and I think it's been longer than 3 years we've been doing this. But each year, it's been a wonderful experience for me as a teacher to see the possibilities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 3 hours is a short amount of time to get the entire car painted with limited colors. So they're having to mix and blend and erase and clean and repaint. And so I think it's great for these kids. And they're obviously having a good time.
We have Frank Dixon here also.
Yeah, my name is Frank Dixon. I'm also an art teacher at Quartzill High School. It really is a fun event, I think, for the kids. It's a different experience. They're painting something bigger, not just a small picture. And they make the smaller design, and then they get to see it all painted on a car. And I'm looking at the car right behind you there they're working on, and it's looking good, and they're having fun doing it. It's a memorable day painting cars like this for the kids.
We wanted to heavily incorporate the overall theme of don't text and drive. We want to incorporate clocks that if you're texting and driving, you're running out of time, and you're not paying attention to what's really important in that time that you're driving. And also wanted to incorporate cell phones and keyboards falling off onto the sides here to incorporate that, like, you're losing your direct concentration on what you should be doing. Just get away from the keyboard, throw the keys away, and want to have letters be an overall theme. And then of course the idea of possible death, that if you text and drive, you have a chance of not being alive anymore. So, and then at the same time, we want to have a little bit of our own personal theme into it. So we thought, steampunk sounds kind of cool, so why don't we incorporate the two together? And so we thought that was great because then we could have pipes all over the car and leading and creating a nice composition on the sides and the front so that the pipelines can be like everything's connected. Everything happens for a reason, and you don't want texting and driving to be the reason that you crash or distracted from the road. So all over here, we have the keyboard on the front, the kind of the reflection of the person who's texting instead of driving. We have the red to kind of represent death. And of course the gears and levers, everything's kind of disoriented and breaking apart because you're not concentrating on what you're supposed to be doing. And all across here, we wanted to also incorporate the steampunk thing and have it kind of have our own little personal voice within the overall theme of Don't Text and Drive. And we want to have a solid, unified color base of grays, browns, and reds, so that way the car overall had a nice unity and a nice composition.
Explain what steampunk is?
Steampunk is based off 19th century technology, that if technology did not go into the digital age and instead went into the industrial. Everything being powered by steam, computers, automobiles, everything being powered by steam instead of conventional gasoline and electricity. And at the same time, punk being a rebellion. Thus, the change away from history as we know it. Instead of going with 19th century technology and continuing on a different path. So that is the definition of steampunk overall that we wanted to incorporate into Don't Text and Drive.
My name is Jennifer Padilla. I come from Highland High School, and we wanted to portray that even though something may seem impossible or like looked down upon, you should still go for your goals if that's what you're really interested to, which ties into the quote, things are only impossible until they aren't. And as you can see, we went for a more fantasy theme with like the silhouette dreaming up a possible lifestyle or a possible like idea, and it just keeps spreading around the parts. It's like symbolic of like spreading all over the world and trying to get that hope up. So
that's it. So tell us about the other screen.
Okay, so here we have a waterfall and then a dragon winding over it, and the dragon's supposed to like symbolize wisdom. And the waterfall like purifying it.
Uh-huh. Wow. So that's cool. It, so. He goes all the way around. Oh yeah, he goes all the
goes
way
all the way around to the back.
Big dragon.
Mm-hmm. Good, I'm glad you like it.
In fact, the waterfall comes over the roof.
Yeah. It goes both ways.
My name is Zoe Reinhardt, and...
My name is Eric Perez-Eckler. We're both students from PHS High School.
And our whole theme for this car is green energy.
Vehicles like this Nissan truck are very... They guzzle up a lot of gasoline, and essentially all those fossil fuels, they promote pollution and destroy the environment, and it's basically about time where we need to start looking at alternative fuels. I mean, PHS High School, we're already looking into different alternative fuel projects. We're looking into the solar car project, which this upcoming year we're going to be participating in the solar car race in Texas. Another project we have going is the e-power project.
With the P-Power project, the science kids, they all are getting together and...
The science kids are getting together and working on different ways we can harness the power. Because if we can extract the hydrogen from the urine, we could use it as energy to power cars, power electricity, different types. We could basically put fossil fuels on the side and have our future towards alternative fuels. I mean, right here is obviously, you can see it's a light bulb, and what this is supposed to represent, you have the globe here, and then these little red and blue dots are supposed to represent the hydrogen atom. And that means, and what this means is that we could harness the power of urine and power everything globally. Different people were poverty and everything, where they don't have access to electricity, we could use urine to have easy, efficient hydrogen energy that could power the whole globe.
And this is the actual logo for our school for the e-power project. And then while we, on this part we put PHS plug into green energy, but all the vines from the flowers and everything else, they all have the outlet plug.
And thus representing green energy. Harness power from nature that comes from our own bodies and use that to power our modern day appliances. And then also here we have the earth, or where we're living right now, in the form of a flower. And what this is supposed to symbolize is that earth is a place where nature and everything coexist together. Everything's balanced. And if we can balance out our electricity input and our output, basically balance everything out with nature so we don't destroy nature, we could preserve the beauty of the planet.
Hi, I'm Jose Valencia, and our theme that we did was Day of the Dead, also Dia de los Muertos. So what we did here was we decided doing this as combining for remembering the victims of texting and driving. So like how they got in a car crash or anything like that. So they die. So what we did was we honored them like how the tragic they were in by a car accident. So that's how we like celebrated.
The teamwork on every one of these was, I thought, exceptional. And so we actually were split. We weren't unanimous. We had our favorites. In the end, we had to pick somebody because that was our job. And we didn't want to because they're all good. And would have loved to give it, I think we talked about that, give 4 awards. We would have loved to have done that. In the end, we chose this one. This is Quartz Hill, I believe. We chose Quartz Hill. We like the theme. We like how the pieces were tied together. We like the use of the texting and the letters and then we all agree we don't know what the heck steampunk is, but it was a cool concept and it tied everything together, so we went with this one. So congratulations, you guys did it all.